The Purdue Wildlife Area is used for a large number of different research projects. One project in particular is a project examining how tiger salamanders, which are amphibians, breed. So what you're looking at here is a drift fence. This is a technique by which we can intercept amphibians on their migration towards a breeding pond. And so many amphibians will overwinter in grasslands or in forests, and every spring they'll leave their overwintering sites and migrate to a pond, what you see behind me. We'll dig a trench, we'll take the fence, we'll bury the fence into the soil, cover the soil back up. Salamanders and other amphibians will walk down the fence, not see the pitfall traps, fall into the traps, and they're captured and held there until researchers can come along and pick them up.
Look out!
Researchers will come every morning and every afternoon and check the traps to ensure that the animals aren't held in the traps longer than necessary. So there are several ways of getting DNA from a salamander. And one of the ways that you can get DNA is to take the tail and take a small tail snip from the tail, and the tail will regrow or regenerate, and it's relatively painless to the salamander.
Well, this is a tiger salamander egg mass. If you look closely, you can actually see the individual embryos within this egg mass. We can take a small tissue sample from these embryos, in addition to the tail snips from the adults, back to the lab, extract DNA, and then conduct the parentage analysis.